Because my point was, when interest rates rise, and you have to admit they could rise, right? I mean, Murphy's Law, anything that can go wrong will. Let's say rates rise, and all of a sudden the federal government needs $1 trillion a year, $1.5 trillion a year, just to pay the interest on the national debt, let alone any of the retiring principal. How are they going to get that money in a recession? Because if rates rise, we'll be back in a recession, the banks will be failing, housing prices will be plunging. How can we put
anything can happen. All I can say is that I think we are in the age of deleveraging. That's the title of my book, and as long as it's selling well and it's number one in Amazon's bestsellers on investment books, that's my forecast. Beyond that,
Americans,
you're on your own.
But the government, but I'm just the government saying, is borrowing like never before. Wait. People are still using credit cards. They're still borrowing money.
No, they're not. They're paying down their credit cards. Look at the data. The credit card borrowing, which is called revolving credit, is dropping like a rock. Consumers are paying
consumers
down
are deleveraging, right?
Which consumers?
U.S. consumers.
U.S. consumers.
Well, then how are they buying all these Christmas What about we had a record Black Friday and Cyber Monday? Where's all that money coming from? Because they don't have any savings.
Oh, yes, I'm the great pretender. But no one can tell. Oh, yes, I'm the great pretender. Adrift in a world of my own. I play the game, but to my real shame, you've left me to dream all alone. Crown.